वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभा निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा
चेयरमैन सर।
गुड इवनिंग लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, टुडे बीइंग द फर्स्ट डे ऑफ नवरात्रि आई विश यू ऑल अ हैप्पी नवरात्रि। मे गॉडेस दुर्गा ब्लेस अस ऑल विद गुड हेल्थ हैप्पीनेस एंड प्रॉस्पेरिटी। वी आर नाउ इनटू द 11th लेक्चर ऑफ बीआई मुंबई सेंटर मंथली लेक्चर मीटिंग सीरीज एंड आई एम हैप्पी टू इन्फॉर्म यू दैट द वीडियोज ऑफ ऑल द लेक्चर्स आर ऑन द यूट्यूब एंड ऑफ बीआई मुंबई सेंटर। Please visit the channel, see and like the videos and subscribe to the channel and do not forget to press the bell icon so that you will receive the notification. You are all aware that insurance is a means of protection for financial loss. It is a form of risk management primarily used to hedge against the risk of a contingent or uncertain loss. An entity which provides insurance is known as insurer, insurance company, insurance carrier or underwriter. Today we would be briefed about the various insurance instruments available from the construction industry. We will be briefed about contractor's all risk policy, that is car policy, as to why one should take it, whether due to mandatory by RERA, financer of as self cover. I am sure most of you are aware of that car policy is a comprehensive insurance solution designed to cover a broad spectrum of risk to which a civil construction project is exposed to, from arrival of construction material at site till the completion of project. We would also understand if the premium is worth taking a work contract policy and will also be given an insight into it. Lastly, we have the liability cover, which I am told it is very important for contractors and subcontractors. I hope Sri Dev Chamal, our today's keynote speaker, will touch upon the present situation vis-a-vis insurance. I welcome Sri Dev Chamal on behalf of BI Mumbai Center. I also welcome Sri Baburav Chakravarti, our Vice President Best, and Sri Bharat Wagh, our State Chairman of Maharashtra, and senior dignitaries from all over India. I also welcome all the participants and wish you all a very, very informative evening. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Maharashtra.
Shakar Sahib, for request.
I request Chakravarti to say a few words.
Good evening to all. Mr. Mohinder Rizwani, Chairman Mumbai Center. Shri Bhagwan Rao Ji Devkar, past president, and all members, honorable members of BAI, throughout India. Good evening to all, and hope everyone is safe and doing fine in such critical situation. Firstly, I would like to put on record my sincere appreciations to BII Mumbai Center for its continuous efforts in keeping BII members engaged and informed. I know it is not easy to be so active in such a critical conditions, but hats off to Team BII Mumbai Center. BII Mumbai Center has been choosing topics for the lectures, meeting series very, very perfectly, very, very correctly. And it is furthermore appreciable that all these lectures are on YouTube channel of BII Mumbai Center. Today's topic, insurance for construction industry, is very, very needed, very, very essential for the contractors, particularly under the present circumstances. We would like to know as to what happens to those contractors who are at present insured, and whether the clause of various construction industry insurance policies will provide relief to the insured contractors. If I am not wrong, RERA has made or was to make title insurance by real estate developers mandatory. I expect today's keynote speaker to throw light on it. I am sure in another couple of hours, we all will be more enlightened. I wish Mumbai Center the very best and best wishes to all the participants also. Thank you. Thank you very much. Jai Hind, Jai Maharashtra.
Jai Maharashtra, Jai Hind.
Awak Sahib, can you unmute yourself? Can you khud ko unmute karna?
Okay. Thank you. Shri Dev Chomal, the present cluster head. With Reliance General Insurance, Shri Dev Chomal has worked 16 years with insurance companies and insurance brokers in Mumbai, like Liberty General as an area manager, Shri Chola MS General Insurance Company as an area manager, India Nivesh Insurance Brokers as Associate Vice President. Also worked with Universal Fombo General Insurance Company and Messrs. Royal Sundaram General Insurance Company, etc. He had completed EMBA in Insurance and Risk Management. He has a Diploma in Business Management from NMIMS Villepalle, Mumbai, and is a BCom graduate. He had completed few insurance certifications and exams like Licentiate in Insurance and Broker Qualified Person. He has dealt with insurance of few construction related projects like Mumbai Metro, Delhi Metro, Mumbai Rail, Monorail, few road projects, tollways, real estate projects, and engineering projects, etc. He also authored articles and have contributed many articles in our Indian Construction Journal of Builder Association of India. He will be keen to advise on insurance related matters.
I think we will listen to Mr. Bharat Wag. Wag Sahib, yeah. Unmute kara swatala. Na Wag Sahib, unmute kara swatala.
Unmute kara tumhala.
Bola, Wag Sahib.
Oh, kela na sir, jala na.
थैंक यू मुंबई सेंटर चेयरमन मोहिंदर जी आज कंस्ट्रक्शन इंडस्ट्री का जो इन्शुरन्स है त्या संदर्भात जो वेबिनार बोलवला आहे खूप सुंदर कल्पना होती कारण खूप कॉन्ट्रॅक्ट बिलमधून इन्शुरन्स कापला जातो पण तो कसा क्लेम करावा या संदर्भात कॉन्ट्रॅक्टरना प्रॉपर गायडन्स नसतं. आज माझ्या मते हा जो वेबिनार होत आहे याच्यातनं आपल्याला सगळ्या कॉन्ट्रॅक्टर्सला एक चांगली दिशा मिळेल ज्याच्यातनं आपल्याला भविष्यात काही अडचण असतील इन्शुरन्स संदर्भात ते आपल्या सॉल्व्ह होतील अशी अपेक्षा करतो. आपले वेस्ट झोनचे प्रेसिडेंट व्हाईस प्रेसिडेंट बाबूराव शक्करवार उपस्थिती बोलवण्यात आलं त्याबद्दल धन्यवाद. थँक्यू व्हेरी मच.
थँक्यू भरद्वाजी.
थँक्यू. स्टेज इज युअर्स.
गुड इव्हनिंग अँड थँक्यू मधु सर. थँक यू मोहिंदर साहब. थँक यू मिस्टर वाघ. जयप्रकाश जी थँक यू. And thank you, the association, to give an opportunity to share some insight about insurance, you know, for construction industry. I'll just try to finish the session maybe in 25 minutes, and then we'll take up the question answer session with the kind permission of the chairman and Madhu sir. Let me share the screen with you, and before that I come across lot of you know lot of contractors, lot of clients. They say iski tumhara premium itna hai, how much is the premium, we should try to save, we should try to avoid. So I only have a question ki when people have problem in paying premium, you know, it becomes big premium, so claim agar aayega to how big it would be. So this is just my submission. Let me just share a small brief. Allow me to share the screen.
I allowed you.
Okay.
Down below share screen.
Okay. Yes. I believe the screen is visible to all of us.
Yes.
Okay. Let me just start. We are discussing about insurance for construction industry. Now, as I just shared, what I come across is, in this session, we'll just try to answer few of the questions. The first question is it worth taking car policy, workman compensation policy? So many times, our contractors, our team, they are, it is made compulsory. So is it worth? We'll just try to understand our principal, few of our principal, they also mandate in their contract tender that it is mandatory to take certain policies. Okay, then our contractors are made to pay premium just because it is made compulsory, one. Second is, many times what we say is ki we have already built the entire thing in my subcontract. In my subcontract, I have already put the obligation of taking insurance to my subcontractors or to my principal. Or when I am raising an invoice or when I am sending a quote for my work, I have already pushed across the insurance liability out of my scope. So this is also one way where people try to save the insurance cost premium. More important is the financier also, they insist on the insurance part. Okay, if you don't pay, many times certain banks, they directly debit the premium and issue the policies. So few of the members might have encountered that particular issue. Let me just try to address these issues. Now, it is a common practice ki let someone else spend. Let someone else take the policy. Now, sir, what my submission is to our members is, now, there is a reason why it is been made mandatory, like MMRDA, BMC, you say CIDCO, other associations, whenever they issue contracts, work order, BPCL, HPCL, and you know, n number of people, they will always make it mandatory. So if the principal has made it mandatory, so either one way is just to follow what the work order says and take the insurance as per the work order and take the cover before commencement of work. This is what my advice is. I'll come the reason why I'm insisting on this. Employee Compensation, and you know, for Employees Compensation Act, it was earlier Worksman Compensation Policy. Now, since 2013, it is made Employers Compensation Act. So even workers, staff, everyone are included. So either you take a Worksman Compensation Policy, that is Employers Compensation Policy, or your EPF or other, you know, mode where the amount is deducted partly by the employer and partly by the employee, but the cover is mandatory. Again, third party policy, lot of contracts will warrant you to, I mean, will insist that third party policy has to be taken. Now, just to give you an insight, just for third party, even Maharashtra has passed a resolution recently, not many of people, many of us know that even there's a resolution recently, Maharashtra lists Escalator and Moving Walks Act. As per this act in Maharashtra, any mall, society, or anywhere where the lifts, escalators are installed and operational, the operator of that particular lift escalator has to take a third party cover. That is mandatory as per the act. Moreover, I'll also say that car policy, if you take, these are the mandatory requisites. If you take a car policy, additionally, you can insure the maintenance part also, extended maintenance part, where the asset is not under your custody, care and control. The example, road. So when you are constructing a road, so you are taking a car policy and other policies. Once you complete the road, there is a 1 year, 2 year extended maintenance warrant contract, which is the responsibility of the contractor to ensure that the maintenance is taken care. So it is also advisable under the car policy, you take it as an extension. Extension as extended maintenance part, you just take as an extension to that. So you need not shell out. Now for cyclone Hyderabad, there is a lot of flooding and all has happened. So the roads and all, it has been washed away. So under the car policy, if there is an extension taken, so these claims are picked up by those policies. Again, I'll just proceed further. Many times it is easy. I mean, since past 15 years, I have come across many people, they say ki mera project complete ho gaya, 90% ho gaya, bill submit kar diya hai. Mujhe abhi policy chahiye. I want a car policy now. Or it happens actually. Ki jab project aata hai, to contractors, principal, they insist on a lot of other things. While submitting the bill, they ask for all the documentations. So I get a lot of requests ki you issue me a policy from January 2020 to November 2020 period. We are sitting in October. We have completed the project. Project is ready. And we have already submitted the bill. Everything is complete. So what happens, sir, is insurance company will take the premium from January 2020 to October 2020 and further from October to November 2020. It will charge you premium. Many contractors will say ki chalo mera paisa us time pe financial issue tha, mereko मैं भूल गया देना या और आई फॉरगॉट और एटलीस्ट अभी पैसा आएगा तो आई इन्वेस्ट एंड देन यू नो फंड फ्लो व्हाट आई से. सो माय आंसर टू देम इज आपने प्रीमियम तो भरना है जनवरी से लेके अक्टूबर तक का. आपने प्रीमियम तो ऑलरेडी भरा हुआ है सब. रिस्क कवर आपने अपने ऊपर रखा. प्रीमियम भरा इंश्योरेंस कंपनी को, रिस्क उसका इंश्योरेंस कंपनी के बदले आपने अपने ऊपर रखा. क्लेम अगर आता insurance company who has charged the premium to you, okay, claim agar aata, you would have borne the loss, okay, agar aapka July, August, you know, even March mein bhi claim aata, the policy wouldn't have triggered because you have not paid the premium that time. My submission to you is here is take the cover when you commence the work. Jab aapka excavation chalta hai, take the car policy that time. Okay. So, by the way, paisa to utna hi lagna hai, premium utna hi lagna hai. Let's actually enjoy the cover for the amount we are spending, sir. This is my submission. More important, last important point is, in case a project started in January, we have taken policy in the month of October, claim comes in November, okay, before completion of project. Now, again, if there is a claim there, it is not going to be a smooth flow of reimbursement of expenses. So, okay, because we have not taken premium, you know, in time. We have not taken cover from inception of the project. Okay. Now, again, other question is, people will say that my job is, you know, excavation is one contractor, then, you know, civil is separate contractor, piling, you have piling rigs and all those machinery coming in. So these are separate contracts awarded. How do I club the entire thing together? And how do I take insurance in advance? Because my contractor is not been finalized. My excavation contractor is finalized now. How do I take cover now for even civil? Because my civil ka contractor final nahi hai, main policy mein kaise dalu? So for that also, there are provisioning in the policy. If you commence the cover in time, there are various provisions under that. You can insure, you can add the contractors, you can remove contractors, you can add subcontractors, and lot of things you can do once you commence the policy in time. So this is my submission to our members. And more important is, okay, let's understand the costing part. Costing part is, see, just to give you a ballpark figure, for 1 crore rupees cover for a existing residential building, it is 4,900 plus GST is for Mumbai. So for premium is not expensive. Okay. When I'm talking building under course of construction, again, for 1 crore, we'll just end up spending about 15,000 odd rupees. Okay. So whether it is mandatory to insure or you are insuring yourself, the premium for general insurance is not that expensive. Let me convince you on that, sir. Now, with this, we just try to answer part of the questions for, you know, our members. Initially, when we started the session, before we started the session, we had few of the questions from the members. We just tried to answer part of it majorly. I'll just come to the second part of my presentation, wherein we are discussing about contractor all risk basic cover, what it covers. And, okay. Let me share the second part of the presentation. Okay. For the members, now car policy, contractor all risk policy, we have certain terminology. For example, debris is called rabbit. Okay, so, you know, so contractor all risk, CAR, and also we call it as car policy. Now, policy covers, okay. Now, what I suggest is there is a 7-page handout. Okay, after our presentation, after my presentation, and after we finish the Zoom session, please share the email address to Madhu sir. So, they may share the docket to your ID. Okay, post session, please communicate with our Madhu sir. Okay, just to move further. what car policy will cover, it will pick up all the losses for location risk, which I was talking, fire, lightning, theft, burglary, house breaking. Then it will cover, in fire, there are a lot of cover what policy will pick up, car policy, which will take care of right strike, malicious damage, impact damage by external means, accidental, inundation, flood, all these are covered under your car policy. Then handling risk also policy will pick up, falling objects, collisions, failure of cranes, these risks also policy will pick up. Then human error, policy will pick up like right strike, malicious damage, as I said. Terrorism, additionally, you can take by paying extra premium. Earthquake for Mumbai, Maharashtra, for current zone, the existing rate, same policy will pick up. For zone, other zones, you need to pay extra premium for earthquake. Act of God perils, policy will pick up storm, tempest, flood, inundation, recent cyclone policies, you stay covered for that also. Apart from that, most important is landslide, rock slide. So this is also covered under your car policy. Now, landslide, rock slide, it's very common in hilly area, mountain, and especially when there is specific soil conditions. Apart from that, car policy, we also insist that car policy is already mandatory as for most of the contract. Now, legal liability, third-party liability policy, it is mandatory when you are using an escalator or lift. Most of the construction project, you are using a lift for your own staff or for moving the material. So it is, believe that it is mandatory from this law also, apart from worst contract or work order what you have got. Even though it is not there, but it is advisable to take a third-party cover yourself also. I'll come to the discussion why I'm insisting on it. Now, Worksman Commission policy will pick up, it's a comprehensive and continuous policy. If your project is for 3 years, 4 years, 2 years, so policy will continue as it is with the same insurer. When commencement of insurance risk, the insurer who is there at the beginning of the policy, same insurer will continue throughout the policy. After some time, if you want to change the insurer midway, it is not possible in the policy. It is practically not possible. Okay. Although policy will have the terms, condition, you may say that I will want to shift the insurance company, but as an insurance professional, I'll advise you not to do that. You will burn your money, sir. So while commencement of the policy, same insurer will continue for contract all this policy, same insurer will give you cover for third party liability policy. Okay. Now, same insurer, you will buy cover for contractors, plant and machinery. These are the machineries engaged by the subcontractors or contractors at the site. We are talking crane, forklift, forklift and other machineries. Now, I'm just adding on to worksman compensation policy. It will also understand policy is covering the, defect in workmanship also. And policy has an provision to cover design defect. D3, D4 policy may cover. So, but these cover, you need to ask for additionally. By default, a design defect is not covered. So you need to ask for a lot of add-on cover in car policy. Now, just to give you some pointers, what I have just noted down for, especially for construction, for most of the clients, I advise them that whenever a principal is taking a car policy, he should take himself as a principal and add all his subcontractors under car policy. And together, the entire construction cost is to be built as a sum insured in the car policy. Additionally, If possible, there is a clause called waiver of subrogation clause. Now, if you are a subcontractor in any of the project and you are part of, if it is said that as a subcontractor need not take a cover, principal has taken a policy. So you should do is you should check that there is a clause called waiver of subrogation clause in the car policy. So as a subcontractor or as an EPC contractor, it is, or even as a principal, it is good to have this particular clause built in. Also, you should have 72 hours clause also built in. Now, why 72 hours? So subrogation is, you know, I'll not elaborate. In case you need any specific input on any of my clauses, I'll just share the entire clause structure also to you. You can read the entire structure. Plus, in case you have any doubt, you can come back to me later also. Now, I'll just skip through the presentation so that I can finish more, I can cover more ground in limited time with your permission. 72 hours clause is basically in 72 hours, whatever claims hit, it is considered as a single claim. Okay, so one deductible is applicable, not four deductible. Example, cyclone aya today morning mein, and there is a damage, there is a loss to the property. So this is one claim. So there is one claim, so there is one deductible. Example, if there is a CPM mein above 50 lakh ka aapka machinery hai, to deductible is 50,000 rupees deductible in each and every claim. Example. So one loss, 50,000 rupees is deductible in the loss. In the evening, there is inundation. Okay. So this is the second loss. So second loss, again, 50,000 is deductible. Although the work will start later, but actually it is one loss and second loss. So similarly, in 72 hours, whatever are the losses, so there is one single deductible applicable. This is the reason why I insist that you buy these additional 72 hours clause, you know, in addition to buying a car policy. Now, there are certain clauses. I have just listed down about 23 clauses what a car policy, principal and contractor and subcontractor should look at buying. I'll not discuss more, you know, but you should always, you know, because the cost is not much, but it is worth buying it. I'll just come back on the second part. When we are talking about car policy, any project, you'll have a lot of construction machinery also added to it. We are talking about cranes and other thing. Now, one thing we need to note is in CPM policy, contractor plant and machinery policy, the deductible is 50,000 rupees in each and every claim where the sum insured of the entire location is above 50 lakh rupees. So small claims, these policies are not meant for small claims. Okay, so let me share the coverage part. The policy picks up the partial loss, total loss. Policy will pick up the replacement of the asset. Replacement, repair cost. So both are payable. So you need to submit the repair bill, estimate bill. Now here what happens is, example, just to give you example. Suppose for a machinery, you have the dealer will give you a bill of 30 lakh rupees, example. So you need to submit the repair estimate bill for the machinery to the insurance company, along with the, you need to inform the insurance company that there's a claim loss. Insurance company will appoint a surveyor, and then you need to submit the repair estimate bill. Once you complete the repair estimate, then the amount is credited to the person who has incurred the loss and the person who has, you know, insured for CPM. Important thing to note is the name you mentioned in the CPM policy and the name of your company, the spelling and all should be taken care. Please, you know, so that you avoid the other hassles. I'll just add on a few of the clauses what you should look at. Owner surrounding property you should insure additionally because your own asset is moving around. Clearance and removal of debris will additional cover you should buy. Customs duty additional, express freight, buy additional cover for express freight because aapka machinery idle rahega na, to aap immediately aap by air mangaoge usko because the cost of air freight is far less than keeping your machinery idle. Third party liability you should always take. Now there is anyone third party liability mein, there is anyone accident and any number of accident in a year, that clause we can just look at 1:1 and 1:4 clause. Now the third cover what we always advise for construction is worksman compensation. I even though I advise or I don't advise, it is written in your contract. just to emphasize, MAHARERA again, it is mentioning Worksman Compensation Act as mandatory. BMC, all contracts, it is mentioning Worksman Compensation Act. Now, here interesting is, one thing we need to notice, Worksman Compensation mein, suppose Mr. A has already has a Worksman Compensation policy covering all his employees, for all his contractors all over India or all over Maharashtra. Okay. So here what is happening, in case there's a claim, it has to be an annual policy, you know, for the company, for that particular company. So all the employees are covered there, one. Now here it is possible, when you take an annual policy, midway, request the insurance company to add the name of the principal. Suppose you are working at BPCL site, ask for an endorsement under your annual WC policy to add BPCL name and just attach that policy and endorsement and share it with BPCL. I'm just giving an example, so that you need not buy additional policy just for that particular work. So this option is available. Now, in Worksman Compensation, you can also add subcontractors in the same policy. Acha, I encounter a lot of questions. People say, my subcontractor is going to buy. Main nahi kharidta hun. Mera subcontractor kharidega. Maine contract mein likh diya hai. 10 contractors are working in my site. So let 10 people buy the policy. So I'll save premium. I'll save the cost. Many of the principal they will say, or many of the contractors they may look at. So my advice to them was, if in case main contractor is buying a policy and he can cover all the subcontractors under WC policy and all the workers at the site location. So what happens is there is no gap in the coverage, one. And at the time of claim, only site location ka aapka wage register and documents manga jayega. Only that particular site location. Okay. In case there are 10 contractors and 10 contractors have different WC policy. So if there's a claim in one WC policy, so surveyor will ask the wage register of that particular contractor ke all the contracts ka wage register he may ask for. And there, in case there is under insurance, claim is not payable. So I'm just emphasizing that, you know, taking a cover this way, you know, as a umbrella cover, take an umbrella and cover all the subcontractors under that. So this is advisable. Moreover, in WC policy, it will pick up Fatal Accident Act and Common Law and Worksman Compensation Act, three act policy will cover. Now, this particular policy is standard with all insurance companies. So whichever company you pick up, it will pick up all the three acts. Interesting thing to know is you can also get an extension for medical extension. You can buy medical extension under Worksman Compensation policy will pick up all the expenses. Medical expenses also, maybe up to 2 lakh rupees you can buy. The premium is not much, but policy will, you know, pick up that expenses also. Either way, this, in case there is an accident at your site, you are exposed to funding all the medical cost of the worker. Now, one thing to note, sir, is if your employee is injured, it is under Worksman Compensation policy. If employee of another contractor who is working the same site is injured, okay, that is not covered. So you are insuring only your contractor, sorry, your employee under Worksman Compensation Act. Okay. Now, this is the other part is, you know, we discuss about Worksman Compensation now. The other part is the last part is the Commercial General Liability, CGL. Commercial General Liability is normally CGL is optional cover. You know, people say that this is a luxury cover. Now, this is the cover you should buy just to protect your company, your entity, your business, your balance sheet, your profit. Okay. Now, CGL policy will pick up all, it is an operational risk policy. Like fire loss aaya to fire policy will pick up, third party loss aaya to third party loss will pick up. Now, any loss because of your operational work, So CGL policy will come to your rescue. So this is other policy which we advise. Now policy will pick up, you know, premises liability risk. It will pick up advertising injury also. It may pick up, fire material damage at the rental premises. Medical payment, there is no limit, there is no deductible, and there is no question asked. In case there is a claim under CGL policy and there is a medical expenses for your customer or for a person other than, you know, your employee, policy will, there is no question asked, the amount is paid directly. So normally 35,000 is the normal limit per person. You can increase the limit case to case basis, but maybe 35,000 is again a decent limit to start with. So what I suggest is third commercial general liability people can opt for to protect your books, your profit, your company, your business. Other thing is additional cover, as I advise you, 72 hours clause, sudden accidental pollution is, you know, additional what you can look at. There are a few additional cover you should look, you can look at. One more thing is liability arising out of travel of executives. This is also can, this also can be covered under CGL policy. So the write-up will be shared with you, so you can have a look at it, you know, further. Now there is a claim scenario also, you know, given, you know, just to give you example under CGL policy, grading activities piled up on earth side. Okay. Now this has slipped on the third party premises. So recently, just to give you example, Delhi government has issued a show cause notice to PWD for pollution and other thing. Okay. So I'm just saying is there liability and claim also keep coming in during projects and also there is a lot of cover which can help you. This is just small case scenario. Motor vehicle accident, again, just because of road work. Now again, this particular claim, suppose there is a accident because there's work going on at the road construction site. There is a motor accident there. And the root cause is found out is the work, what your team has done or your engineers or team are doing. So there the policy will pick up that loss also. Now, most important part, sir, is we need to know is in case we are talking about liability side, sir, asset side mein toh aapka jo loss hoga, that policy will trigger. Liability side, what expenses aata hai? Matlab, chota mota kisko nuksan ho gaya toh kya problem? Matlab, what is the quantum of expenses policy will pick up? We need to understand. Just maybe 2 minutes, I can just extend it further the discussion. The liability expenses, what liability will pick up is, liability claim will pick up all the expenses pertaining to the defense cost, court fees, advocate fees, your all the, you know, court penalty, okay, in case it is found guilty. Now policy will pick up only till the time you say that you are non-guilty. You have to say that you are non-guilty and then policy will come to your defend. Moment you say ki, I have done a mistake, sorry, maaf kar do mujhe, ye mistake ho gaya sir, ye ra policy le lo, third party policy, se claim le lo. Policy will not trigger, policy will not pick up that loss, sir. So one thing, in any liability policy, please do not share, disclose liability policy with any third party person. One, it is mentioned in your policy clause. Two, never admit the liability yourself, because agar aapne liability admit kar di, to policy will not come to your rescue. If you are defending, policy is there to defend you. So if you are saying that I am non guilty, policy will come to your rescue. So in moment there is a liability claim, I always suggest that immediately rush to your insurance advisor, rush to insurance company and take advice, what is to be done. Please do not communicate or take any responsibility or without the consent of insurance company. Please do not go ahead and execute something. You should always immediately, in case there is any loss, immediately see the policy will support you. If there is a property damage loss, it's car policy, fire policy, try to save the assets, try to save people, try to save them by one. Shift the material at different location. Yes, policy will cover the expenses, fire policy will cover the expenses 60 days. If the material is shifted to a different location, 60 days, if it is materially sitting there, policy is covering that 60 days period also at a different location also. So I'm just sharing at the same premium, no premium charge. So I'm just sharing at the time of loss, at the time of claim. I am sorry that I'm just extending the conversation further. At the time of claim loss, especially in the liability side, please take care of any medical expenses, emergency hai, take care of all the medical expenses. Usko ensure karo, you know, the medical is taken care. You know, do whatever possible to minimize the loss, reduce the loss. One. Two, whatever you are doing, take the consent of the insurance company, claims officer ko phone karo, toll free mein phone karo insurance company ke, give the policy number, speak to the claims officer, he will advise you what is to be done. One, the person, the engineer who is at the site or your workers who are at the site, ensure that there is no body injury, property damage to your staff or even the third party. So try to protect whatever possible. Policy is there to protect you. But negligence, please see, although there are policy covering negligence also, but as far as possible, experienced people, it is expected not to be negligent about thing. Just the next part is there is a professional indemnity policy which takes care of the negligence and error and omission of the professionals. Okay, just to give you example, any adverse advice by insurance professional, insurance broker, there is a professional indemnity policy which is there sitting as per regulation by IRDA to protect the insurance broker. I'm just giving example. So similarly, there are doctors, chartered accountants, engineers, there is a professional indemnity policy available, they should buy. One. Number two is there are a lot of companies who are into engineering projects they execute. So they should buy a commercial general liability policy with certain extension. Now, one more thing, sir. Many times our team, they will engage the external, will buy car policy and they will buy an they will engage the external architect, external engineer. You'll have a, civil engineer, you know, external. So ask the civil engineer who is not on roll to buy a professional indemnity policy and submit to you. Okay. You may think that I'm just main kharcha bada raha hun aapka. This session was meant to save the cost, but please, and what my purpose is, if there's a claim triggering on one policy and it is said that because of design fault, architect or design fault, say if claim high hai, so insurance company will wait for the report to come. So if you have this particular policy in place and you submit this policy also, then insurance company will not wait for the report. The root cause of that particular loss, is it because of design fault or is it because of workmanship defect? Okay. Or is it because of negligence and error? So purpose is to buy all the policies, cover clauses in such a way that in case there is a clause, we don't give any chance to the insurance company to repudiate the claim. Okay. Professional indemnity policy will pick up, you know, investigation, defense costs, settlement, you know, clause, all the costs for professional indemnity policy will pick up. I'll just end up. Okay. Professional indemnity cover, there are a lot of extension. There are a lot of case studies. I'll not go in detail about it because of shortage of time, but I'd like to add one more thing. Most important is how to save the cost. This last part of my discussion, how to save the cost. Now, people are preparing the, you know, colonies and a lot of things to ensure that the employees are retained. The retention of employee and getting the employees again, quality employees again, a challenge right now in the industry, with few of the industries. Now, what you can look at is, there is a group health insurance policy you can buy for the employees. One, It will pick up everything, including the maternity. You know, you can pick and select the cover clause. COVID, it is Maharashtra, it was made mandatory. Any site, any company, factory site, you need to have the COVID cover in place when you are commencing the work. There was a GR issued by Maharashtra government. This is in the month of April. So one is a group health policy you can buy for the employees. Second, group personal accident policy you can buy with group personal accident with medical exchange you can buy, which is the cheaper option than group medical claim policy. Other thing is you can buy a COVID GMC policy also separately. Okay, COVID GMC policy may be 600, 700 is the premium per life, but you will pick up the COVID related claims only. Now there is another option available. Workman commission policy, so you will buy to satisfy the work contract. Okay. Or to satisfy the law of land and all, WC policy or other policy. This is GMC's top-up GMC. Now, top-up GMC is a cheaper option. One is 1 lakh rupee taka expenses, let the employee bear from his pocket. Above 1 lakh expenses, this policy will trigger. Or it is assumed that most 1 lakh, 2 lakh people will be having the policy. Employee will have 1 lakh, 2 lakh policy of their own personal policies or whatever way they have. This additional policy you can buy, you know, from 1 lakh to 5 lakh, 1 lakh to 10 lakh rupees. So 1 lakh, 1 rupees to 10 lakh, you know, whatever expenses policy will pick up. There is another way. There are a lot of contractors and subcontractors. He's on my role. He's not on my role. So this super top-up policy, GMC, it also has an option. You can insure non-employer-employee relationship also. So for a project, you can look at buying this policy that 1 lakh se upar ka loss hoga to policy will pick up medical expenses. So this is one marine policy people should look at buying. Director officer liability policy is there. E&O error omission policy people can buy. Most important, sir, before I submit my discussion, before we start to the question answer session. Now, contractor orders policy mein, you can insure the transit cover also, aapka material which is coming to the site, that particular marine insurance is also covered under car policy. Okay. Then commissioning, now erection of the civil and all work, it is policy is covering that. Now, many times as I just shared here. Okay. Now, under CPM, contract plant and machinery, many times you are going and erecting a machinery at a different site. There is something called as marine cum erection policy, which is available. In marine cum erection policy, the transit of the CPM part or crane parts are covered, plus the erection of the crane at the location or erection of the machine with testing policy is covering the entire leg. So even during testing time, if there is a loss, damage, policy will trigger the claim and the claim is admissible. So what my submission was, car policy, when we take car policy, picks up all the expenses from the transit of the material to the location, excavation, plinth, piling, first slab, entire slab, you know, commissioning of the entire building, or if it's a road project, then car policy will also extend to extended maintenance part. So that way also. And the last part is the third party liability, marine, D&O policy you can look at. Error omission, there are cover available. Now, these are all the cover available provided you opt for. So all these policies are there to protect your balance sheet. And last part before I submit, in case there is a loss, third party liability loss also, it is going to reflect in your balance sheet. Aapke balance sheet mein wo liability claim dikhega, auditor remark aayega ya aayega. When you submit this balance sheet to a banker for loan or for next project, so any or tenders, like now MMRDA, certain companies, they ask for the balance sheet also, financials also. Then they're finalizing the terms when they're shortlisting the vendors. So when you see in your balance sheet, aapko liability mein aapko 50 lakh ki liability dikhegi, 50 crore ki liability dikhegi. So it will spoil your balance sheet. So just to protect your balance sheet, you should look at buying a third party liability cover, director officer liability policy, your other liability cover. This is the reason why people spend on third party liability policy. Now, with your permission, we can move to the question answer session.
Thank you, Mr. Dev Chaman. I would like to begin the Neero sir. Mohinder sir, you have to. Mohinder sir.
Yes, Madhu.
कुछ बोलना है वी विल बिगिन द क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन
जय स्टार्ट द क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन
ओके
दिस इज योर रिसीव्ड द क्वेश्चन आंसर इन ईमेल
हेलो
आया 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 कंटिन्यू
मिस्टर नीरव परमार आवर पास्ट नेशनल सेक्रेटरी एंड इंडियन कंस्ट्रक्शन जनरल कमिटी चेयरमैन सब बोलिए
या कैन आई आस्क
Please, sir.
No, because I have just come outside. That's why there will be some disturbance. Yeah, Mr. Dev, I have two questions for you. First, mainly is this car policy is in place and COVID has come. And this has prevented stoppage of work as well as neither it is in the inclusion list nor it is in the exclusion list. So how does it protect the person who has taken the policy?
Okay. And second question, Mr. Neero.
Yeah, I think you want me right now. I think second question, what I wanted to ask was regarding the professional indemnity. I think which you have covered. So it was mainly on that part. And the second question is regarding, as you very rightly said, that the principal contractor should buy all the policy. I mean, should cover up everything, the entire project. That is in the interest of the project, and it brings, there are no gaps and there are no overlaps.
True.
So I think that is one aspect, but how do you keep on adding the subcontractors to that? And also throw some light on the subrogation part, which you said you will take up during the question answer session.
Right.
Thank you.
Thank you for your query. See, now with this COVID time, this is pandemic. Now there is a clause in all the insurance policy that this global pandemic is an exclusion in all the policies. Whether you buy fire policies, ER, or any other policies, this global pandemic is an exclusion. Plus there are other exclusion what we should know. Policies having exclusion for war, civil commotion, nuclear, and any mass destruction, the policy is having an exclusion there. So here, and second question was how to cope up with that. Now, for example, your car policy was about to expire in the month of July. Okay. Now it is bound to, you are bound to stretch this till the month of maybe November. Okay. You need to go back to the same insurance company and request for the extension of the existing car policy. One, see, there is no way, see, in case there is a loss, except you, there is no one who is going to suffer the loss. So it is at your interest and the interest of the principal where, you know, the work is being executed, that the policy has to be extended before the expiry of the policy. Okay. So this is what you should do. One, you should pay the premium for July to November or maybe further and take the extension in the existing policy itself. One. Number two is what is to be done. Iske andar hum kya kar sakte hain? See, the cost escalation is another thing. Policy is not going to respond to you. So that is there. Policy, what you are supposed to do, and there is a waiver which is given recently. In case there is a project which is a standstill position or you have stopped the project because of one or two reasons, you need to inform to the insurance company. Same thing applies with a factory project or anything. If the running condition is a factory, is suppose the factory, there's a lockdown for more than 30 days, you need to inform the insurance company that the factory is non-operational. So it is a silent, the word is, the phase is, it's a silent risk. you need to inform the insurance company. Even the pandemic also, you need to inform the insurance company that the work is not operational. There's no one in sight. It is a silent risk. So pass an endorsement there. One, if it is a operational policy. Other question was, sorry. Hope I've answered the issue.
Yeah. Understood. So you mean to say the clock stops ticking once it is notified to the insurance company that the work is not going on.
Yes. And more, it is your responsibility. That way. One more thing I remember before we started the session, there was a query about title insurance. What was discussed about title insurance. Now, title insurance, if you see the Maharera clauses, it is made mandatory. Apart from worksman compensation policy, third party liability policy, and title insurance, again, it is mentioning that. But people are not buying it. Okay. So the contract has it, but since it is not asked for, emphasized on, so people are not buying it. But still the Maharera will still say the same clause that it is mandatory. It's like wearing a seat belt or
meeting in a room. Yes. Okay.
Nirav sir, aapka ho gaya?
हाँ मेरा हो गया लेकिन एक अभी इन्होंने जो ये थर्ड इसका टाइटल का क्या आई हैव जस्ट रिमाइंडेड ऑफ वन क्वेश्चन डू यू हैव एनी प्रोडक्ट विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द 5 years डिफेक्ट लायबिलिटी पीरियड व्हिच रेरा आस्क्स द डेवलपर टू गिव द गारंटी फॉर दैट
देयर इज अ प्रोडक्ट अवेलेबल इन रीइंश्योरेंस मार्केट वेरिन इन इंडिया आल्सो द प्रोडक्ट कैन बी ऑफर्ड नाउ हियर इट कैन एक्सीड अप टू 10 इयर्स द डिफेक्ट पीरियड बट यू नीड टू बाय At the commencement of car project.
Absolutely. It cannot be at the end of the project. The date has to be from the commencement of it. Yeah.
Yes.
But those, what would be the approximate cost of that particular product? Just a ballpark cost in terms of percentage.
There is no quote. I've not seen any quote less than 10 lakh rupees. And deductible is 6 lakh rupees minimum. Sorry, 6 to 8 lakh rupees is minimum deductible in the policy.
Fine, I think I am done with my questions. Thank you. Yeah, Mr. Chairman, I am done with the questions. We can take up next questions.
Madhu.
Hello.
Krishna ji, boliye.
Sir, thank you very much. Dev sir, I have a small two questions.
Please, sir.
One is this car policy started all of a sudden, where government declared that 1% is to be deducted or 1% is to be paid to the insurance, and the whole work, whatever is the contract amount, that is to be covered under the car policy. Once the work is taken up 1 crore rupee, 1 lakh rupee or little sum, less or more, is to be given to the insurance policy, but that work hardly get completed within the stipulated time. There again, department insists to get the policy renewed. This renewal, is it the cost or it is subject to the contract amount?
Okay, good question. And this is a good question, Mr. Rajiv ji, because this is a practical scenario with many of the cases wherein the project is being extended because of XYZ reason. Now, see, you have paid premium to the insurance company till the month of October. Example, okay, January to October, you have paid the premium. You are extending this project from October to January. Example, so you need to pass two endos. You need to request the insurance company to extend the date from October to December or January. This is one part. Number two, if there is a cost escalation in the contract, which is happening as a result of extension of the project or delay of the project. So you need to increase the sum insured also in the car policy. Now, when you increase the sum insured in the car policy, the sum insured increase happens from the commencement of the policy, that is from January, example, January. So from January, insurer will charge the premium. It will come till October and it will charge the premium from November, December, January further. So,
Should I?
Yeah, please, sir.
Yeah. Suppose the contract amount is 1 crore rupees and escalation amount is 3 lakhs rupees.
Mm.
1 crore, 3 lakhs rupees. So once the insurance policy is being taken for a crore rupee work, it extend for 3 lakhs rupees total.
Mm.
Whatever is the contract amount plus escalation, only that amount is to be considered while asking extension. Whatever is the contract value and day when I'm applying for the renewal, the escalation amount worked out by the government, that bill copy is quite sufficient to get the extended insurance.
Right. Good and practical.
See, my questions are, a little critical.
It is practical question.
See, I am facing number of things. You have seen from last 10 years, the things I was searching a person like you. This is my questions may take lot of time and other people may not get chance. I'm taking your number from Mr. Madhu and I'll come back to you. I'll talk to you personally.
Yes. Agreed, sir.
Better.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Krishnaji.
Yes, sir. Madhu sir, thank you very much.
Thank you, Krishna ji. Yes. Next question is from Mr. Ajay Poddar. I will just ask him to unmute. Kindly unmute, sir.
Hello.
Ji, Ajay ji, boliye.
Sir, good evening, sir.
Good evening, boliye.
Sir, in the car policy, I have one question. We are using this scaffolding materials.
Please.
Hello. Hello.
Yes, Mr.
In a car policy, we are using the scaffolding material like staging, shuttering, you know, angle, channel plate to construct the bridges and all these things. So is it a part of the car policy, sir? If there is damage, anything, can we get the insurance for coverage for this scaffolding material also?
Okay. Okay. Now, Mr. Ajay, Now, ye loss kiska hai? Is the loss of scaffolding, damage to the scaffolding, is the loss is of the principal or the loss is of the contractor?
Contractor, sir. Because we are using that structures to build the bridges.
Now, in car policy, you CPM you can cover under car policy up to 25 lakhs sum insured.
Sir, question barabar.
I understood. Okay, let me frame the question. What I understood is, if there is a damage to scaffolding and CPM asset of the subcontractor or contractor, which is at the bridge or construction site, so how will a car policy pay the claim or whether it's admissible or not? This is the question.
Correct, sir. Correct, sir.
Okay. Now here, sir, when we are buying a car policy may we insure the project one, there is an additional section that up to 25 lakh rupees sum insure or up to X percentage, you can insure your CPM also, contractor plant and machinery also under the car policy that principal can insure for his subcontractors. One. So under the same, because it is advisable to go under car policy because the rates in CR policy are cheaper than buying a separate CPM policy.
Correct.
Okay. So that is one. So you buy a car policy ke saath mein CPM cover you add kar lo aap usme. So your shuttering material and other things are covered. One. Number two, suppose as a businessman, as an entrepreneur, it's your business, your machine, your asset, which is engaged in one site location. It is also advisable to take a separate contractor plant and machinery policy separate for yourself, for your one site separately, which covers transit insurance, shifting that material to the location, plus erecting that material at the site location, erection part, plus testing part. Okay, the entire leg is covered. That is erection always policy. Plus you take a contractor plant and machinery policy after the erection is completed separately also. So
okay.
ऐसा जैसे है ना माजा कुटुंब माजी जवाबदारी ऐसा स्लोगन है महाराष्ट्र में. सो इट इज योर असेट सो यू शुड इंश्योर अदर रादर देन लीविंग इट टू समवन एल्स.
ओके सर ओके ठीक थैंक यू सर माय क्वेश्चन इज ओवर.
Hello. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Dev sir, in the introductory my speech only one question I have put with you.
Yes.
Another question is, once we buy policy for the period of time limit given in the work order, 3 months, 6 months, 1 year.
Mm-hmm.
We want to take extension for that work. The work is not completed. And we are going to take the extension. We have forgotten to extend the policy also.
Okay.
Time limit is over.
Okay.
Department is deducting full amount again. Once we have already bought it, once we have already paid. Again, we have to, department is deducting 1% from our bill. Is there any alternative?
Right. There is a way out, but that way, that is not advisable, you know, always to do. See, you have taken a car policy, and after some time, the, you know, the maybe project is yet to be completed, but the period is over, policy period is over.
Yeah.
Whenever you want,
yeah,
not wherever, whenever you and insurance company agree to, see, you need to go to the same insurer who has insured your car policy. Same insurer ke paas jaake, you have to submit certain documentation, insist them, and the same insurer can issue an extension to car policy from the date the, you know, policy is expired to the future date. And it has to cover the vacuum period also, the period where you have forgotten. So you have to pay the premium to the insurance company also.
I have already contacted them. They are saying that the time limit is over. Extension time, given extension time is over.
Okay.
Already over. Extension time. We cannot renew it.
Okay, see, what I can do is I cannot give any commitment, but I suggest just share the details with me one to one. I just try to help you. I'll just try whatever way I can help you.
So I will contact you personally.
Yes, yes.
Hello.
Yes, yes.
Shall I contact you personally?
Please, please. Yes.
Okay. I will take your number from Mohinder.
Yes, please. Please.
Okay.
I'm also on LinkedIn. So you can Thank search you. Me on LinkedIn also anytime. I'm there.
Don't worry, sir. I'll provide you the number. Sanjeev Shah will ask a question.
Yeah, good evening, Dev sir.
Good evening, Mr. Shah.
Yeah, I have one specific question. You know, supposing a contractor is doing a bank protection work near a river and he has taken a car policy. You know, after that, supposing because of the flood, the structure has been damaged.
Mm-hmm.
When the structure was damaged, the insurance part people, you know, talked to the contractor and told him that be very nice to the insurance company. You have to understand that this is also a part of the nation building. And try to reduce the claim as much as it possible.
Okay.
So when the contractor reduced the claim, after a few months, they took out one page from that book, Gita of Insurance, and told him that it is because below 5% of the total cost of the project, you cannot now get any claim. Is it true? And which was not told to them at the earlier stages?
Actually, Mr. Sanjeev, what happens is one, all policy comes with a deductible. Okay. Actually, in any policy, there are a couple of parts. One is it comes with a deductible.
Right.
And the deductible is just to give you a some figures. 10 crore to 100 crore, if there is a fire policy, 10 crore to 100 crore sum insured, the deductible is 25,000 rupees or 5% of the claim amount.
Right. Okay.
So the purpose of framing this deductible in the policy is that insurance company do not want the small claims to hit to the insurance company, and the policy is there for the big losses. Now, second is request to reduce the claim amount, request to reduce the losses. So if you are the owner of a business, you will also try to reduce the loss, reduce the claim. So insurance company is just representing you. So insurance company, if they are saying that please reduce the losses, try to reduce the loss, try to save the asset, or you know, do something to prevent the further losses. So they are not wrong, because you would have also done the same thing. So I will rather say this way, ki the deductible will happen as per the policy terms condition. While framing the policy, you need to look at the deductible, what deductible you are opting for. Car policy, if you want a quote, example, if I give you a quote for 10 lakh rupees for a car policy for maybe 3-year project, if you want this particular policy from 3 lakh, ki 1 lakh rupees mein mujhe policy, mujhe 60,000 rupees mein policy bana ke do. Example bol raha hu. If a person say ki ye 3 lakh ka quote hai, mujhe 60,000 rupees mein ye policy bana ke do, aisi car policy ban jayegi with all the cover, but the deductible would be 10 times the normal deductible, or 15 times, or 20 times the normal deductible. So this provisioning is there in the car policy with the insurance company, with the client, with the intermediary. So what we advise you is ki when you buy a policy, aap usko usme clause jo hai na sir, deductible, ye sab padh lo aap usme sir, ek bar thoda time nikal ke padh lo, or you consult an expert who can read the entire thing and give you interpretation. Because there is another part, jaise aapka claim ho gaya, there are a lot of clauses in warranty. The warranty, there is a fire extinguishing system in the place. That is warranty, standard warranty in all the policies. Aapke the fire extinguishing system rakha hi nahi aapne. Warranty dala hua hai sir policy mein. Ab how will policy respond? So this is one. Second, warranty that there is no basement exposure. You will see this warranty also in many of the policies, standard warranty in all the quotes. So you need to correct that in the quote itself, and when the policy is shared with you, you please correct that remove the warranty that there is no basement exposure, because I have got 2 basement parking. So I'm just sharing that, please correct that at the policy itself and take an endorsement to that.
Yeah, I just wanted to ask, it was not on the basis of the loss which was covered. They took the total claim amount, what was the policy was taken on the total amount. Of that, they took the 5%. I know, is there such claim or not? I'm not aware about that. Another thing, I have some very spectacle question, that whenever you go to any insurance agent, he will always talk all about the goodies and the putties and he wants in policy. But he's never interested in telling what are the problems which a person is going to face when he's going to put the claim. And that creates, because nobody has the time to go and read it, every small letter. It is like going to a bank and getting a loan. You sign it every paper and you don't know what you are signing it.
True. Agreed.
So how do you get out of this base simple problem? It's a very simple thing, but it is connected to everybody.
That is true. And one is the trust factor. You have trust in the person who is who is intermediary. Before extending that trust, it's actually, you need to find the right intermediary, right person. So there is no prescriptive guidelines to find that.
Okay.
I don't have an answer there, but
okay,
that is your wisdom and judgment to find who is the right person to take care of your portfolio.
Right, sir. Okay.
Only way is I can just tell you some basic benchmark figures.
Yeah, please.
Benchmark is, see, the insurance, there are insurance agents, insurance advisor who are there in the industry for long. So you can find out how long the person is in the industry, whether he's holding those particular clients, past and all. So you can just have reference checks, about the insurance intermediary also. Then second is, in IRDA site, there is a list of all the agents of all the insurance companies, all intermediaries of all insurance companies. So if you visit IRDA site, you can see all the intermediaries there also. So this is, you know, information available in public domain in IRDA site. Plus all insurance companies, they on their site, you'll see the list of agents also. So that is also authenticated document.
Okay.
So this is what I can see. The person who is meeting you, he may share more about himself.
Yeah, true. The problem is that we don't take care much time. We don't give much time to this. That is a problem because it is a subsidiary thing for our contract. So that is the biggest problem. I understand. I think we should take care of it. Thank you very much. Thank you for throwing light on it. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Sanjeev.
I have one question. The car policy premium is based on the contract sum. is only nearing the completion of the project that we are aware of the actual cost of construction. Very often there is substantial saving in the contract amount and there is a lot of saving. So then the original car policy is taken on the original contract sum, which is very much higher. So at the end of the work, can we claim a refund of the part of the proportionate part of the premium that has already been paid if the saving is not for any fault of the contractor? For whatever reason, the scope of work is reduced and the contract is completed in all respects with a lot of saving. Then how do we go about claiming refund of the car policy premium that is already paid on the original larger contract amount?
Mr. Verma, one is when we have the documented evidence of the revised contract value, that information, if you feed to the insurance company, okay, they may pass an endorsement to the sum insured. So once the endorsement is passed, the refund for the balance period, the procedure follows, because insurance company may refund the amount where the risk exposure doesn't exist. So refund is available. Just to give you another simple example, if there is a factory, or you know, you have maybe 50 crore ka sum insure. So after 10 months, you say that my 50 crore sum insure is only 5 crore sum insured now. So from 10 month ke baad se 11th and 12th month, your premium charged after endorsement is only for 5 crore sum insured, not the 50 crore sum insured. So this is how you need to go back to the insurance company and get the endorsement done.
I am seeking advice for a case wherein the work is completed. The work is completed and we are aware of it only on completion of the work or near completion of the work, when there is hardly any period left, that there is substantial saving. And the car policy continues for the maintenance period or for whatever the defect liability period and all that. But then the actual work, value of work done is much less than the amount paid for it.
Actually, case to case, actually for this particular case too, I need to read the policy coverages, documents and other things. Only then I can advise you anything on that. Because without going through the clauses, I cannot advise anything, sir. On this case,
in the beginning of the work, we cannot anticipate, you know, and say, okay, yes, there is going to be saving. So obviously we pay as per the premium worked out, you know. So this problem we face at the end of the work. You know?
Mm-hmm. One thing is there, during the extended maintenance period, you can change the sum insured. I mean, the sum insured can change actually in the end of extended maintenance period also. Now there is a saving available, one. Once you pass the endorsement, backdated ke liye, I need to refer the documents.
Thank you very much.
Okay, Mr. Anand Nair.
Yeah, hi everyone. I'm Anand Nair from Hypara Construction. Grateful for BAI to organize this. Dev, my question is very similar to what Sanjeev had raised. The substance is similar. Mm-hmm. Where the contractor all risk policy by the name, we would expect that it covers all risks. But as like based on some discussions, wherein some of the participants asked how would certain risks be covered. So for every question, the answer was, you know, for this, for example, like your CPM policy or some other policies, some additional policies have to be taken. So I would have assumed that it's a very comprehensive policy, covers most of the risks. So would like to know, instead of the inclusions, what are the exclusions which would be, you know, which would, what are the risks which are not being covered under this CAR policy, and whether almost many of those can we take with the help of the extensions? Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Anand. Mr. Nair, your question is correct. See, because very as a businessman, we are interested in knowing ki I paid the premium, so everything is covered. And it is assumed that everything is covered. Okay, now the ground reality is the CAR policy contractor all risk. It is covering all risk. All risks are covered. Now, all risks except the exclusions. So all CAR policy will have the exclusion. Example, main sab kuch khata hoon except non-veg. ओके तो मैं सब कुछ खाता हूं मुझे ये चार चीज अच्छी नहीं लगती तो एवरीथिंग विद एक्सक्लूजन सो कार पॉलिसी में स्टैंड देयर आर सर्टेन स्टैंडर्ड एक्सक्लूजंस कार पॉलिसी में आपका वो पेंडेमिक का बाय डिफॉल्ट देयर इज एन एक्सक्लूजन वॉर सिविल कमोशन देयर इज एन एक्सक्लूजन इट इज स्टैंडर्ड एक्सक्लूजन देयर इज अ कॉन्सिक्वेंस देयर इज एन एक्सक्लूजन ऑफ कॉन्सिक्वेंशियल लॉसेस देयर इज एन एक्सक्लूजन आपको consequential losses and owner surrounding property there is an exclusion that you have to pay additional premium and take as an extension in car policy then there are certain exclusions and there is an there are extensions available to most of the exclusions so it's like you know it's like framing a policy because insurance company will have a standard car policy with standard exclusions. So just to give you a insight, car policy will cover a debris removal cost also, which is 1% of the claim amount. Okay. We typically call it a rabbit. So, but 1% of the claim amount in South Mumbai, you cannot remove debris. Because the cost is too high to remove the debris from the site and dump in respective allotted location by the authority. Now, debris coming from Bombay Central or Wadala, authority will not allow you to dump anywhere before Panvel site. I'm just giving an example. So 1% of the claim amount में आपका debris removal नहीं होगा सर so it is advisable आप car policy में extension ले लो debris removal cost from 1% you increase the amount up to 10% you can go similarly there are a lot of cappings restriction in your car policy so you need to you know take extension you know as an extension आप ले लो उसमें so this you can do it while framing the policy at the inception stage आप बीच में वंस यू कमेंस द पॉलिसी आफ्टर 2 years आफ्टर 6 months 8 months आप बोलोगे मेरे को डेब्री रिमूवल कॉस्ट बढ़ा के चाहिए वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर द इंश्योरर टू एंटरटेन दैट पर्टिकुलर यू नो रिक्वेस्ट सो राइट एट इंसेप्शन प्लीज फ्रेम इट करेक्टली जस्ट टू सम अप योर सम अप द आंसर नाउ स्टैंडर्ड इंश्योरेंस कंपनी विल गिव यू स्टैंडर्ड एक्सक्लूजंस स्टैंडर्ड एक्सक्लूजन आपका रहेगा इसके अलावा सीपीएम इज एक्सक्लूडेड टनलिंग वर्क इज एक्सक्लूडेड ब्लास्टिंग वर्क इज एक्सक्लूडेड ओके सो इन केस यू आर डूइंग ब्लास्ट गोइंग टू एग्जीक्यूट द ब्लास्टिंग वर्क यू नीड टू गो बैक टू द इंश्योरर एंड गेट द एक्सटेंड यू नो रिमूव दैट एक्सक्लूजन सो यू नो इट इज एक्चुअली इट हैज टू बी केयरफुली यू नो क्राफ्टेड थिंग्स आर crafted perfectly, framed. You know, people say that many times when I see the policy, I always say that it is beautifully framed. So people say that ye guldasta hai kya jo aap bol rahe ho, beautifully framed. It is like it has to be framed, you know, correctly. A car policy. So that's, I mean, I just try to answer it, but I cannot list down, you know, there are 23 extensions in car policies. So you can understand that there are 40 exclusions. So uske samne 23 extension hai, sir.
Theek hai. Devji, I think there are no more questions from the participant, but I have some questions from the registration form. I'll read it out.
Please.
You just say yes or no, or you have answered it. Mr. Raj Chettiar and Shripad Dinkar Gune from GL Constructions, please state what are the benefits of car policy. I think that we have covered.
Okay.
What are total benefits of work compensation policy? That also we have covered. What are benefits of non-deniability status?
Benefits of non?
Non-deniability status.
Okay.
Unfortunately, Mr. Gune is there. Please raise your hands from GL Constructions of Sunil Matreja. ठीक है उनका आगे क्वेश्चन से आर देर एनी स्पेशल बेनिफिट्स इन कंसिडरेशन ऑफ कोविड 19 ऑल्सो एनी बेनिफिट्स पर्टेनिंग टू हॉस्पिटलाइजेशन वॉट आर स्पेशल बेनिफिट्स टू वुमेन
ओके फाइन आई हैव गॉट अ स्मॉल आंसर टू दैट देर आर स्पेसिफिक कोविड पॉलिसी अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट देर इज कोविड जीएमसी पॉलिसी अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट यू कैन बाय कोविड जीएमसी एज पर मैंडेटरी रिक्वायरमेंट बाय महाराष्ट्र गवर्नमेंट सो दिस इज अवेलेबल There are individual COVID policies also available. You can just buy individual policies to your team, 10 people, 5 people, and hand over to them. COVID policy is cheaper than your Mediclaim policy because Mediclaim policy is 3 to 5% is the cost of sum insured. COVID policy is far less. So you can go for that. Women for women, I mean, there is no special reservation or categorization. I have got a product.
Okay.
I don't remember. Sorry.
Okay. Okay.
Insurance is a vast subject. I don't remember a product specifically for women for construction.
Shall I go to the next one? Mr. Amol Raut from Akash Developers. Would taking an insurance for a project help in case of delays and cost overrun due to municipal permission, COVID-19 related RERA expenses? He's talking about real estate project.
Okay. Okay. Now, Mr. Amol, see the...
Are you there, Mr. Amol? A-M-O-L. No, he's not there. Okay. Please.
Okay. Your car policy and your fire policy, CPM policies are either, you have to say ki the reason why the loss has happened. Municipality delay and all, there is no policy which will pick up this particular loss. Okay. Because it is beyond the insurance company's purview because the policy is not framed that way. One. Pandemic, global pandemic, as I mentioned, that it is a universal exclusion in the all policies. So policy will not respond for that. Number three is because of the COVID and all, if there is a project is delayed, please visit the insurance company and take the extension. So this is what the responsibility of insured. So hope I have answered the three part.
Yeah. Mr. Uday Prabhu, 5 years insurance policy to cover latent liabilities of builders to de-risk them.
Okay.
5 years insurance policy to cover latent liabilities of builders to de-risk them.
Mr. Uday is referring is one of the clause in, by the regulation that 5 years defect-free maintenance, no question asked.
He's a RERA man.
So see, there is a product available, which is called, there are two options available. One is extended maintenance policy you cover. You buy extended maintenance policy in your car policy, that's one. You have a building under course of construction. There is a policy, if car policy is completed, it's only civil work. सील वर्क इज कंप्लीटेड आप फिटिंग फिटमेंट्स वगैरह कर रहे हो प्लम्बिंग फिटिंग कर रहे हो तो बीयूसीसी आप कर लो सो दैट विल यू नो कवर दैट पर्टिकुलर पार्ट थर्ड पार्ट इज द वंस यू कंप्लीट द प्रोजेक्ट हैंड ओवर टू द कस्टमर सो नाउ दैट पर्टिकुलर that particular point can happen, you know, after 2 years of completing car policy, 3 years of completing car policy, you don't know which, when the customer is going to take the position. So there is a inherent defect policy, which is there, which is in international market. Case to case basis, you can buy, but it has a deductible of 6 lakh rupees, 8 lakh rupees, 10 lakh rupees. I've seen the wordings with 20 lakh rupees deductible also. We are talking about $2 million deductible, $1 million deductible. We are looking at in these lines deductible. So, the chota mota repair hai, policy will not come to your rescue. Chota mota seepage hai, chota mota painting defect hai, chota mota repair hai. So, up to 6 lakh rupees policy is not going to come to your rescue, even though you buy that particular expensive policy.
Mr. Gune from GL Construction of Sunil Mastreja, please, bola tumi. Gune sahib, bola. Gune sahib. Okay. Mr. Vedanand from Kanyakumari. Whether car policy covers labor accidents, medical claims and compensations?
Yes.
Okay. I think I will give it to Mr. Anirudh Rakawa. He has a question. Mohinder, Chairman, sir. Chairman, sir,
I'm there.
Anirudh Rakawa, I'm giving him. He has a question. Before that, you want to say something, because then he will make his concluding remarks also.
Sir, my question is, during this lockdown, most of our contractors have been paying salaries and the work is stopped completely. And what does the car policy support in that?
Mr. Mohinder, what now? Car policy will pay in case there is a damage to the insured asset. So where is the damage to the asset, sir? Structure is not damaged, sir.
Chairman, sir, you're through?
Yeah, I'm through.
Let
Anirudh Rakawa, sir. Good evening, friends. Dev, sir, I have a question for you. There is actually a lot more is very much is discussed. This is a very simple question. We have seen about the car policies, the CPM and various types of policies for various contracts. Do you have any product which covers this multiple policies? Because for I am seeing that for every contract, you have a different product. But is there any product that it can be purchased and that policy remains for a general policy which remains for a multiple projects for 5 years or 10 years or so?
Mr. Anirudh, there is something called as CPM, Contractors Plant and, there is something called as CGL, Commercial General Liability Policy, but it picks up only liability losses. It doesn't pick up your assets.
Okay.
So, it will pick up all the liability losses, claims because of your operational liabilities, losses because of your operations. One. You need to look at one is there is a fire policy, which is an annual policy. Every year you need to insure your assets. Okay. Now assets sitting in various locations, you know, you insure your assets for 1 year, 1 year, 1 year, 1 year. It's only 12 month policy. Contractor all risk policy is for the location, one location period of project. And then after project completed, you convert it to fire policy and that's how it is. Now see it is a complex structure rather, not only in India, worldwide, it is a complex structure, you know, in terms of insurance and all. So it has to be crafted. It has to be framed correctly. You know, your CR, CPM, your CGL, commercial general liability, professional indemnity. So there is nothing, a single umbrella nahi hai.
Single umbrella nahi. Yeah, I can understand because the whole session, what we have gone through, there are many complexities.
It is not simple. That's why we call it insurance professional. I call myself as insurance professional.
Yeah, true. So that was all the questions from my side. Now, good evening, friends. What a wonderful session we had from Dev Chomal sir. See, look, this was a very different kind of educational lecture in this lecture series of Builders Association of India, Mumbai Center. And I particularly thank, first of all, for our chairman, Mumbai Center, Mohinder, to give an insight for his extended vision for including taking such a topic which has been never taken and thought for. Because likewise in our life, we see insurance plays a vital part. Similarly, today's lecture have put an insight into how this matters. As a consultant, I have seen many times the government billing system deducts our insurance. So even me, myself, I was not aware till today how to get it back, how that insurance can be claimed. And Dev Chomal sir has, with various, like from your car policies to commercial general policies, the CPM policy, he has also made an insight towards how car policy has the subsidiary policies which can be taken advantages of, 23 extensions which can be made to the car policy, as well as what are the 40 exclusions, the CGL policies which he very now spoke about while he was answering me, assets and liabilities and claims, how they are to be made. Professional remedial measure policy, he also explained with a slight touch how it can be taken off. Group health insurance, and for the recent times regarding the COVID pandemic times, how the policies, which policies take care of it and which exclude it. From this, I also would like to make certain suggestions, because looking at this entire presentation, it's my humble this thing that this platform should be rather more extended to deal with likewise we classification of various policies, because civil engineering and construction industry in itself is very vast, and as you know, civil engineering covers right from the manhole covers to the bridges, from tunnels, mountaineering, engineering, airports, construction of airports, and every chote chote cheezon ka bahut maine rakhta hai. Footpath bhi hoti hai aur bada bridge bhi hota hai. There are construction works going on offshore side and inshore side both. So in all these cases, there are high rises, real estate, infrastructure. So yes, so in all these sectors, how insurance is going to get covered, I think a proper more classification is will be required to ourselves getting more educated on this insurance front, because we as civil engineers, Dev Chomal sahab, aap chinta na kare, because as a civil engineers, humko jab pyaas lagti hai, hum kuwa khodna chalu karte hai, aur jab kuwa khodna ek civil engineer chalu karta hai, wo pani lagne tak kuwa khodta hai. So wo bina pani ka kuwa aise hi chhod nahi dega, pani zarur nikalega usme se. So the fact is, if there are 40 attendees today, you expect to get 80 calls, definitely, because ye 40 or rather 400 calls, because jo aaj jo log baithe hain, they will of course take this presentation home, and they will discuss with their friends and fellows who are not here into this seminar, this lecture series today. And with this, I hope BAI, we as I am also part of BAI, I'm treasurer. We from BAI look into this insurance part more keenly. This is just the first step for the insurance part. I hope we will be going more further and getting ourselves more educated this through this lecture series on insurance part also. Thank you, friends. And I now with all this, I hand over to our chairman, Shri Mohinder Rijwani, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Sir Akbarji, now I request Narendra Panamiji to give vote of thanks.
Yes. Dev Chomal sahab, jo aapne aaj time nikal ke detail mein insurance ke bare mein explain kiya sab contractor ke liye, safety measure ke liye, bahut achhi baat hai. Aur
My pleasure, sir.
More 40 participants bhi the isme aaj. Aur I thanks to chairman, ex-chairman Ganchan bhai and vice president Baburao Sarkarwar and Bharat Vaak sahab. Many, many thanks from BAI. Aapka webinar bahut achha tha aur sabke liye faydemand hai. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. My pleasure, sir.
Thank you. Participants, Dev Chomal ji, this will go on YouTube by tonight or tomorrow morning, and we'll be informing everybody of that.
Okay.
On my personal behalf, thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. My pleasure. Oh, you know, thank you very much for giving me opportunity.
Now I conclude the session.
Yeah. Mr. Pankaj Reddy, if you are there, 1 minute.
Yeah.
I don't think so. It's not. But Mr. Pankaj Reddy, you can come on screen. I was looking for you.
Sir, I was late getting logging in.
He's all the way from Andhra Pradesh, huh?
Yes, sir.
I was looking for you, but you were not there.
I logged in late, sir. Thank you. I was late for the session. I think tomorrow I'll catch up with the YouTube link you'll send, sir.
Pleasure. It's a pleasure, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Good night.
Thank you all.
Thank you. I'm unmuting everybody.
First off, the recording first.
Pause.